Hey everyone, this is Asim from the Programming Geek. In this video, I will show you how to send email in PHP. For this, we will require PHP mailer class. You can get this PHP mailer class from github.com. The link is in the description of this video. So, I am going to use the Gmail SMTP server to send the mail. So, you will require your active Gmail account to send the mail. I already created HTML form to get the receiver mail, subject or message. So I have created an HTML form, and then the form action method is post and action is send mail.php. So send mail.php will contain our mailing code to send the mail. So I already downloaded the PHP mailer class. There is the PHP mailer class. We will require only PHP mailer dot PHP mailer autoload dot PHP. So first we have to include it our PHP code. So we will require directory name / PHP mailer autoload.php. So then mail is equals to new PHP mailer. We have to create one object of the PHP mailer class. So we have the object name is mail. New PHP mailer. So this will create the object of the PHP mailer class as mail, and then we have to initialize, give various parameters to this object. First one, we have to define whether this mail is SMTP or using SMTP or not. So we have to declare it as SMTP. So is SMTP, this will define it as mail object as SMTP. Then after that, we have to set whether to turn or enable or disable the debugging mode. So SMTP debug, then value. If you want to enable the debug, just write 1. If you don't want to enable the debug, just write 0. Then SMTP authentication, SMTP the auth for authentication. Gmail requires authentication, so write it as true. Then SMTP secure, SMTP secure, this will define the security type of the SMTP we are using. So SMTP secure, Gmail requires SSL security, so SMTP secure type as SSL. Then SMTP host, so just type host, not SMTP host. So Gmail SMTP host is smtp.gmail.com. Then port number of the Gmail is 465. We have another option as 587. If the 465 does not work for you, just write 587. If 465 does not work, use 587. I have written it as a comment. Then after port, we have to define whether the our sending mail is in the HTML format or not. So is HTML, it's a method. So if you are sending a mail as HTML format, so just write true, otherwise false. Then mail username. So here username of your Gmail account, You have to type your Gmail account username, your mail @gmail.com. After that, password of your Gmail account. Password Gmail password. Your Gmail password would be here, and your Gmail account email address would be here, from which you are we want to send your email. So send mail, and then after that set the set from. It requires set from. In the set from, write your Gmail ID. This will be shown to the user that who receives this email. So set from the same email ID you are sending it from. Then mail subject. So first we have to fetch that mail to subject and body that we are getting from the user, entering into the index.html for this form. So we have to fetch it. We are sending that very methods mail to subject and message body in the post method. So we have to get it. So I will declare three variables as the mail to, then mail sub, then mail msg, mail message for msg, then dollar underscore post mail to, because we have defined the text box mail to text box name as mail to, and mail subject text box as mail subject, and message is mail message, mail msg. So mail to copy it, mail sub for subject. Then mail message, msg for message. So now we have fetched the variables from post request. Now we have to use it. So after setting the set from, we have to provide the subject of your mail. So subject is equals to, we will pass the variable as mail subject, mail sub. Then require the mail body, so just write body. Again we will pass the mail message. This will be called the mail message variable, contains our mail body, mail message. Then to whom we want to send the mail, so for this we have to add address. This is the method, so it is the method. Then pass the mail to, mail to variable to whom we want to send the message or mail. So our mail object is ready. Now we have to send this mail. So to send this mail, there is a method of the PHP mailer class send. So we have to use the object that is mail, because that's object, we have to use that arrow and then call the method send. Okay, so this method returns boolean value whether the mail is sent or not, true or false. So we have to check it using if not. Okay, if it returns false, that means mail is not sent. So if not, then echo mail not sent. If else mail is sent, then echo mail sent. Okay, so our PHP script is ready. Okay, so I have not entered any value. So to check this value, I have to enter my Gmail, the email user email ID and password. So I will enter my email ID and password and will come back. So So I have entered my Gmail account username and password into our PHP script. So we will check to send, try to send the email. So here I have opened my Gmail account. So no email. So I will send this to subject, the programming geek test mail. So we will try to send. Okay, I forget to give the semicolon. We will retry it. So if your PHP server or server gives the error extension missing open SSL, so you have to enable the SSL service into your PHP script. So you have to edit your I am using your easy PHP server. If you are using WAMP server, just click right click on it, then go to PHP and php.ini. So I'm using your easy PHP server, so I will open it in the dashboard. You have to edit your php.ini file application. If you are using a different PHP server, there will be different method to edit your php.ini. Open your php.ini file, then search for php underscore open SSL. So here is the php.open.openssl.dll. Remove your semicolon in front of this. So this will be enable open SSL service in your PHP script. Then restart your web server. To restart it, I will give my HTTP server. If you are using WAMP server, so directly restart. There is an option here in WAMP server. There will be option here to restart it. So after restarting, it should work. I will try it again. So you can say it's we have enabled the debugging mode here. We have given the value as 1, so it's giving the log value. In the last you have seen that mail sent, it has given the value as mail sent. It's here is the mail is received. Okay, we will try to disable our SMTP debug. So just show this method, mail not sent or mail sent. So just type 0 to disable the debug. We will again try to resend the mail. So this time we will try to send, let's say, 2nd test mail. Let's see whether it sends or not. Here you can see debugging log value is not shown because we have disabled the debugging mode. Let's check whether mail is received or not. Here you can see 2nd mail is received, 2nd test mail. So before using your Gmail account to send the mail, you have to enable your Gmail account to be accessed from less secure apps. So to enable your Gmail account to be accessed from your application PHP or whatever application you are using it, so just log into your Google account. Go to Google and log in. Don't go directly to Gmail, then click on my account here. Go, then click on my account, then sign in to Google. Click in sign in and security menu, sign in to Google. Then in last in the bottom of the page you will see allow less secure apps. So you have to turn it on. I have already turned it on. So if you don't turn it on, allow less secure apps, you will not be able to use your Gmail account to send the automated mail. So you have to first turn it on, then you will be able to send the mail. So that's it. Hope you like this video. Please hit the like button and please subscribe for more videos. Thank you.